Picture this. You just moved to a new city. Over time, you get to know the neighborhood like the back of your hand. You see this building, you know you're on that street. You see this bridge, you know you're near that park. The point is, visual cues are helping you learn where things are. It's the same with students learning science or math. They have to learn abstract concepts they cannot see, like chemistry molecules. Research shows that using visuals can help more than verbal descriptions. You wouldn't describe a molecule in plain English. You would draw it. A picture is worth a thousand words. In fact, you rely on visuals every day. You see red, you stop. You know you need to charge your phone because of a battery icon. But what about a graph of COVID cases or a map of the US elections? As it gets more complex, how do you get better at learning from visuals? That's what I do. My research helps learners extract information from visuals quickly and effortlessly. This is called visual fluency. Here's how I do that. I developed an online training for chemistry undergraduates where they have to pick the correct molecule from four choices. To help them learn, the software gives them two types of feedback: correctness feedback or error feedback. The first type, correctness feedback, indicates whether the answer is correct or incorrect, like the first example in the image. You've seen that type of feedback in a Word document. You get red squiggly lines when you type a wrong word. The second type is error feedback. It tells you that the answer is wrong and it shows you the exact location of the error, for example, using a yellow highlight. Which type of feedback do you think is more helpful? Telling me that I'm wrong or telling me where I'm wrong? It turns out that both help, but the one that helps more is not what we expected. Studies have actually shown that your brain needs a workout. It can get very lazy relying on detailed feedback all the time. In my study, both types of feedback increased student learning significantly. But surprisingly, the more detailed error feedback did not improve learning as much as basic correctness feedback. Why could that be? Well, we know that self-directed learning helps students discover by themselves how to fix their errors. So it's a balance. Online trainings need to use feedback, but not so much that it gets in the way of self-directed learning. The next step will be to determine how much feedback is too much. This line of research is especially timely with the increased reliance on online learning during the pandemic and beyond. So now you know, feedback does help students learn, but sometimes less is more.